In this video, we're looking at the alpha decay of polonium-210, and we're told a little bit of background information about polonium-210. It's part of the uranium-238 decay series. It's one of the daughter nuclei in that decay series, and it has a half-life of about 138 days. And what we're trying to do here is write down the reaction for the alpha decay of polonium-210. And then in the second part of the question, we're going to compute the energy released in this reaction in mega electron volts, or MeV. We're given a reference table that includes the atomic mass unit written in MeV per C squared, and then the mass of our original nuclide, polonium-210, in atomic mass units. And we're given a big hint here about what results from the alpha decay of polonium-210. It's lead-206, and we're given the mass for that in atomic mass units. And finally, we're given the mass of helium-4, in other words, an alpha particle, in atomic mass units. Note that all these masses actually include the mass of the electrons that would ordinarily be attached to their atom. So imagine that we didn't know what the decay product was, we didn't know it was lead-206. All you have to do is look at our original nuclide, polonium-210, and when an alpha particle is emitted, that's two protons and two neutrons in the nucleus. So you just knock down the atomic number by two, and we get from an atomic number of 84 to an atomic number of 82, and then you realize you're looking at lead as the decay product. So as we start to look at the reaction, we're going to look at polonium-210 in its proper nuclide notation. And the atomic number goes on the lower left. That's 84. 84 protons is what that means. Polonium-210 means 210 total nucleons. So then we can get the number of neutrons by just taking 210 minus 84. And this gives us 126 total neutrons. Now again, alpha decay means we emit a helium nucleus, and that has two protons, two neutrons, four total nucleons. And then to figure out the daughter nucleus, again, we've lost two protons, which gives us lead. So we have 82 protons. So we'll go ahead and write lead, this PB, with 82 protons. The alpha particle carried away four total nucleons. So we subtract four from the 210, giving us 206. So we have lead-206. And then the number of neutrons remaining, well, we lost two of those as well. So we have 124. Now to get the energy released in this reaction, what we need to do is look at how much mass has disappeared in the reaction. Then we'll get the energy equivalent of that mass. So we start with our mass of polonium-210, and we subtract from that the mass of all the decay products. There's lead-206, and there's an alpha particle. We could call it a helium-4. Now remember, all the values in this table include the mass of the electrons that are ordinarily attached to those atoms. But with 84 electrons on that polonium-210, 82 electrons attached to that lead-206, and 2 electrons attached to that helium-4, all the electron masses cancel out of this calculation, so it doesn't matter. Plugging in the numbers in atomic mass units, we end up with 0.005802 atomic mass units missing. This is the mass that's been converted to energy in the reaction. We want to convert this to the convenient units of MeV per C squared. And we were given the atomic mass unit in those units, 931.494 MeV per C squared. And I'll post a link to the video where that was first derived. And when we run the numbers on this, we get 5.405 MeV per C squared. Now that number is the amount of missing mass. Remember, those units of MeV per C squared are mass units. To figure out the energy equivalent, well, it's going to be the same number. But to be extra thorough here, what we're doing is applying E equals MC squared, and the mass is 5.405 MeV per C squared. When you multiply that by C squared, those cancel out. And I get my final energy release for this reaction of 5.405 MeV. And we're done. If you enjoyed this video, or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.